gang. It's Monday, the 9th of January, 2017. Welcome along. Sorry, I haven't had a shave yet, as you can see. I haven't been swimming yet. I can't go swimming on a Monday until after 11 o'clock. As you know, I go swimming every day. It's about a 20-25 minute walk from my house to the swimming pool and back again. I could take the car, but it's all part of our keep fit regime. It is. We've got to keep that heart banging away, dear. Bang, bang, bang. Because if you don't, it could suddenly stop. And then who am I to deprive you of my inane chat every day? Yes, almost every... Well, it has been every day since the beginning of the year. I don't think we've missed a day yet. Shall we set ourselves a... Why do I lose these words like that? A target. Shall we set ourselves a target this year of a show every single day? Is that a little bit too much for you? It might be a little bit too much for you. I know we've done some long shows this week, but I had some time off. I had a little bit of... Now, can you hear the cough? Listen, different. Different now. There's hardly anything coming up there. It's quite dry now. Dry, a little bit like my personality, dry. Yes, so... After I finished the show, oh, I haven't had a shower yet. Not a shower. I had a shower last night before I went to bed. Isn't that lovely? The only thing is, I've noticed if you have a shower and then get straight into bed, if it's been a hot shower, you can suddenly get very hot in bed. Have you noticed? Have you noticed something like that? Have you? If you have a shower just before you get into bed, or worse still, a bath, which I found out when I was staying at that Premier Inn. Now, I don't have a bath here. I've just got a very strong power shower. I don't really like the idea of baths. You know, laying in all your own dirty water. It's not my sort of thing, really. So I've just got a shower there. But when I was staying in the Premier Inn in King's Cross, when we went to Disney in November, in Euro Disney, there was a bath there. And I thought, oh, do you know what? I will have a bath today. And I laid in this bath, not too long. And I thought, oh, I don't know about this. You know, it wasn't really that comfortable. It was all right for a while. And then I got out, dried myself off, and went straight into bed. Well, I overheated very quickly. Mind you, the bath was very hot, I must say. So it was similar with a shower. If I have a shower here and I get straight into bed, I can overheat if the shower's been too hot. Do you notice that as well? So the idea is to have a shower, then watch a little bit of telly and a nice cup of tea, and then go to bed. Now, unfortunately, yesterday, before I went to bed, I sat down with my cup of tea and I looked over, and there is a tin of Christmas biscuits that I had left over from Christmas. Now, I was supposed to give this tin out to someone as a gift. It's actually like a triangle. It's a big tin. I gave one to one of my friends in Central Station. I bought two of these ones and I hadn't given the other way. And I thought, well, you can't give away a Christmas gift now to it. I was supposed to could have given it away as a prize, couldn't I? Oh, no, I know what I can do. Actually, they're inside this tin are two packets of biscuits. Now, I've opened one of the packets. Now, before you get too excited, I didn't have that many. I only had about four of them. And they're only small, I suppose. What can I give you as an example to the size of the biscuits that I've consumed? I suppose each one was about this big. And it's in the shape of a Christmas tree. Oh, what do you mean you want to see the Christmas tree shape? Well, I haven't got any scissors here. We can't do Christmas tree shapes here. No, we can't do it. So they're about that big. Maybe a bit smaller than that, actually. Probably about that big and a little bit thinner. There we are. How's that now? Look. And they're in the shape of Christmas trees. I only had four of them. I've just realised there are two packets of biscuits in there. So I've opened one. I could put the other packet back in the tin and give it away tonight, couldn't I? As a prize. The trouble is you've got to be so careful giving away prizes at karaoke. You know, you'll give it away and someone will come up. Oh, I sang better than them. I should have had the prize. People don't accept it, do they, anymore? They don't accept it that actually, you know, and not necessarily the best singer anyway. It's whoever I fancy. Perhaps I should give it away to the worst singer. Or would that be a bit cruel? Because I'd win it then. I'd have to give it away to myself, wouldn't I? Yes. Anyway, so before I had those biscuits and that, after I finished the show last night, we did a live show last night, phoning. I did go for a walk. And it's very nice walking at night. It was a bit foggy, but it certainly wasn't cold. I mean, I left the house with my hat on and my coat done up. And within a few minutes, I'd undone my coat and I took my hat off. My head was overheated. I thought my head was going to burst into flames, dear. It's all very worrying. It really is. So that was the walk last night. And unfortunately, I had a problem with my legs last night. And halfway on my walk, they accidentally took me to the BP petrol station. And I'd gone in there to buy a little bag of crisps. And of course, the old problem was in there again. Two packs for £1.40. So I ended up buying two of the grab size bags. But I only had one bag. I only had one bag and I was out walking for an hour. So I did need some sort of sustenance as I was walking down. At this point, you're probably gathering that the weight loss thing isn't going too well at the moment. I haven't lost anything at all since the beginning of the year. And we've had 9 days. I should have lost at least £3 by now. It's not happening, dear. It's not happening. I must try harder. I have also, since the beginning of the year, I went into Marks and Spencer to do some shopping. And they've got these... Now, I'm not actually a fan of cut bread. I shouldn't really have bread. that's the worst thing, isn't it? But I discovered these packets in Marks and Spencer's of cut bread, but it's like, it's not got any ends. It's like sort of half a loaf in a bag. And it's ever so tasty. Oh, it's lovely. And the other day, I had an entire bag in a day. So that's got to stop. That's where some of the... I've actually put on a bit of weight since the beginning of the year. I can't lie to you. I mean, my... we've got it written on the diary here, haven't we? Yeah, there it is. My 12-stone target for the 8th of April isn't looking achievable at the moment. But we must try. I will try and do my best, okay? Promise you that. So I went out for my walk, came back, had a shower. Then I had a cup of tea, a few biscuits, watched a bit of telly. What did I watch last night? The Voice. The Voice is now on ITV. You remember Saturday night I watched Let It Shine with Gary Barlow and who else was on the panel? I can't remember who else was on the panel now. Anyway, it's like a talent show and he's looking for people to star in his West End show about a boy band. It's not about Take That. It's like what happens to a boy band as they go through and onto superstardom, I suppose. A little bit like myself, you know. I mean, I could write a book myself about how I became, you know, how I was that young, confused boy and turned into the superstar that you see before you. I think that could be put in. I must speak to some of my friends in Hollywood. You know, I mean, who would play my part? I can't think of anyone better to play that part than myself. Although, perhaps a little bit of makeup. A makeup on my face to make me look younger. And talking of makeup on the face, there's another programme I watched. The Real Marigold Hotel. Did anyone see that? Oh, it's excellent. Excellent. It's these four pensioner people. And they're all over 70. One of them's Wayne Sleep, and they go... What they're looking for is somewhere to retire to. And on the last two programmes, I think they only did two programmes this time around. One was in Florida, and one was in Thailand. And in the Florida one, they stayed at these places. And one place, so many other people had facial surgery. And they looked very, very strange. But they all look very happy about their facial surgery. But the trouble is, with a lot of this facial surgery, you can actually tell it's been done. Now, even if you've got poor sight, which I think is like my cat downstairs, I don't think she can see properly anymore. Even if you've got poor sight, you can see my face has not had any surgery, can't you? But what I was looking at this thing, they'd all had some sort of lip filler and you know, the big, you know, the big lips. The big lips are the real giveaway, aren't they? And the face is like, you know, they're all looking like this. And I thought, how strange do they all look? But they all seem to be happy with it, you know. So if someone's happy, fair enough. Let them get on with it. Anyway, going back to The Voice, which I watched a recording on ITV. Excellent. It was really good. Yeah, really good. And nice to see Tom Jones back there. I would like them to, I think, have kept Boy George in there as well. He was very, very funny, Boy George. Perhaps I asked him and he couldn't do it. I don't know. But it used to be on the BBC, of course. It's now on ITV. It's just as good. It's no better and it's no worse. It's almost exactly the same. Except that some of the couple of the coaches, they don't call them judges because they're not nasty. They give them constructive criticism. Will I Am is on there. I love Will I. I think he's fantastic. Wouldn't it be great to have a little night out with Will I Am, do you think? I think he's amazing. I really do. And Danny Minogue's great. And Tom Jones is great. And the bloke at the end. I can't remember the bloke at the end now. What does he do? Is he a pop singer or something? I don't recognise him at all. They always seem to have someone on that end that you don't know as well as the other three. Have you noticed that? And there was a young lad on at the end who was really good, and he did Whitney Houston. I wanna run to you. I wanna run to you. Was that the one he sung? I can't remember now, actually. But he was really good. Apparently, he's already in a West End musical. I think it was in Michael Jackson's Thriller, is in, or the Motown one. Fantastic singer. And it's strange, you know, you hear, I think, something different. It not necessarily sounds different, but in your own head, sometimes you hear things and you think, oh, you know, they've put that one through and I thought he or she hit a few bad notes. And then there might be another one. There was a particular girl on there that I thought was really good. She was towards the end. I think she coloured her hair a funny colour. And no one turned round. And she was in tears and she was so disappointed. And I thought she was quite good. I did think she was quite good. So that's on... is it Saturdays or Sundays that? I can't remember now. Saturdays or Sundays. So there's a lot of talent shows on at the moment, OK? And I gather there's a dance one on now on Sunday nights on ITV1 as well. I haven't seen that yet, so I might try and pick that up on the old catch-up. Lovely to see my very good friends Vectis Humphrey and Shania doing a little video Facebook Live show the other day. Now, those two, they do a radio show or radio shows on Vectis Radio on the Isle of Wight. This is at the moment only just an internet station, but I do believe in an internet radio. I don't understand why it hasn't become bigger, and it's never pushed, is it? You never see adverts on the telly for internet radio, really. Sometimes you might be listening on your home radio at home, and it might be kind of mentioned in passing. You know, this is, I don't know, this is Radio 2, 88 to 91 FM, are from the BBC, also available online. And that's all they say, also available online. Well, that doesn't sound like internet radio. It is, you know, online means internet, but they don't call it internet radio. It's never really pushed. And yet, you can get some wonderful apps. I've got a little app on my iPhone. Tune In Radio, it's called. Tune In Radio. And there you can search for radio stations about anything you want. You could have 70s music, 80s, 90s, soul, R&B, rock music. And all these stations, that's all they will play. And then I would look for a radio station with personalities like Tony Blackburn, Dave Lee Travis, Vectis himself and Shania, all wonderful personalities. There's religious stations on there. There's Muslim stations. There's Catholic stations. There's Jewish stations. There's French. Everything is on there. All countries, French, German, whatever you want. It's all on there. Tune In Radio. And yet it's never pushed. And I don't understand that. You don't see it advertised on the television. Anyway, Vectis and Shania, at the moment, their station is internet only. And it's called Vectis Radio, as I say. And they're trying to get... Well, they've got a community FM licence. I think they've got that now. But they're trying to raise money to actually get the stuff together, because, you know, you've got to have premises and then you've got to have equipment. You don't have to have the best equipment in the world. I actually do question that sometimes. You know, when you go to some of these, or you see some of these little community stations, and it's all very wonderful. You know, they've got the best equipment everywhere. And it's all laid out beautifully in this purpose-built studio. I question that. I do question that. Do you actually need to have that? You know, I'm sitting here. Okay, you can't see everything around me. I've shown you so many times. But generally, I've got a couple of computers, a mixing desk where the sound all goes through, an old thing here, an amplifier over there, and a couple of speakers. I mean, what more do you want? If this was a radio station, number one, you wouldn't see me, which is probably not a bad thing, to be honest, is it, eh? You wouldn't see me. And it would sound, you probably wouldn't notice any difference. If it was all done from just one studio, you know, while the news is on, I could hop foot out of here, the next bloke could come in and sit on the same chair and carry on. Wouldn't it? You know, so I do question whether you need very expensive equipment. I think you could probably do it all at Maplin's, dear. Not that this programme is sponsored by Maplin's, or even better, John Lewis, dear. They've got all the stuff in there. Or just one of those DJ shops, djkit.com. I mean, so what if you haven't got the best gear? Just get on with what you can afford and do it. So they are trying to raise money at the moment. So they're going to be on FM in, I think it was the Newport area. Because I was watching their little Facebook Live. They do Facebook Live videos as well while they're doing it. And they're so lovely. They're very warm. It's a father and daughter. And the banter that goes between them is really nice. I was watching one this morning. And Vectis is doing this thing with his face at the moment. We go, like that. Can you do that? Now, do bear in mind, if you've got a headache, it's going to make your head... Oh, I've had my pills this morning. Yes, I have. Yes, I did with my tea. If you try that yourself, you might get a bit more of a headache. You ready? Let's do it together. Are you ready? One, two, three. How long can you do it for? Shall I try 10 seconds? Here we go. Right. Oh, I don't think I could do any more than that. I actually feel dizzy now. Do you feel dizzy? Yes. Dance yourself dizzy. This is Boogaloo. Thank you very much for your messages on yesterday's show. Thank you very much to Rachel, who sent me in a picture of Auntie's Barry Manilow grotto that she has in her house. Now, if you want to look at that, just go on my Facebook wall. My Facebook is Chris Reardon UK. So facebook.com/Chris Reardon UK. And you'll see it. You see the picture of part of and Barry Manilow grotto with pictures of him all over a wall. Is that a gold disc you've got there? It's just underneath yesterday's show, dated the 8th of January. Okay, so that's all up there. Hello to Ray Reynolds, who says, "Hi, Chris. Tell Kevin, who rang in from Worthing yesterday, I was the DJ for a while at the Bull and Pump in Shoreditch. We used to have Dockyard Doris, Dave Lynn and others on cabaret nights. Heffin and David had..." Is it Heffin or should I say Helen? Heffin. That sounds very German, dear. Anyway, Heffin and David had the pub before they moved to the Crown in Hackney. And I DJ'd there as well. And belated birthday greetings to Bill Buckley, who I remember on Two Counties Radio and LBC and used to chat with at King's Cross. He's a good friend of Bobby Crush and William Broughton in Browham in Australia. Bobby Crush on the old piano. He always used to be smiling, didn't he? How can you smile so much, dear? Ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, 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 ding. Yes, thank you very much for your comments there, Ray Reynolds. We do appreciate anyone who sends comments, all right? Now, good news for ladies, if you want to breastfeed your children in church. Here we go. Pope Francis. Oh, credo in unum deum. Pope Francis encouraged women attending a ceremony in the Sistine Chapel. I've been there. Oh, wow. If you ever go to Rome, you must go to the Sistine Chapel. I will warn you, very, very busy. Very busy. It is stunning. Stunning. And of course, that's where he goes to pray. Pope Francis has encouraged women attending a ceremony in the Sistine Chapel on Sunday to feel free to breastfeed their children inside the church. The Pope said the service in the Vatican was a little long and that mothers should go ahead and breastfeed without fear. Well, that's fair enough. But it's gone a bit that... I'm sorry, Pope Francis. I hope you're going to vote roll that out for everyone. I mean, I get a little bit peckish at church sometimes. Surely, if that's the case, I should be able to take around a few little sandwiches, perhaps, a couple of bags of crisps and a flask of tea, and sit there, especially when the priest is doing the sermon, because sometimes... Oh, God, when is this going to finish now? You know, it's a little bit like that sometimes. So please, Pope France, can someone write or possibly cut and paste this part of the show and send it to Pope Francis, letting him know that we fully support the fact that ladies can now breastfeed themselves, their children, in church, in the Sistine Chapel in the Vatican. But therefore, can we roll that out to all his other followers and please allow us to bring packed lunches and flasks of tea or possibly fizzy drinks? Not that I recommend fizzy drinks for anyone, boys and girls. You'll have no teeth. You see all the people on the Jeremy Kyle show? They all drink fizzy drink. Every last one of them. Black teeth. Oh, no. Oh, or one tooth that is black. God, don't you think, I'm not being funny, don't you think if you got down to one tooth and it was black, wouldn't you take care of that little one? Eh? Oh, my word. Anyway, so hopefully we'll be able to take sandwiches to church soon. He made the comments during a gathering on Sunday where he baptised 28 children at an annual ceremony commemorating. Oh, I hope I don't have that question at the quiz. I'm just putting a quiz together, actually, for Wednesday at the baptism of Jesus. So that's lovely. That's really lovely. Now, if you are vegetarian or you want to become vegetarian, if you are vegetarian already, this story won't bother you. But if you're not and you want to become, check this out in this morning's Super Soraway Daily Mail. New vegetable-based burgers that taste more like meat than real beef and even sizzle and bleed are arriving on plates. Here's something new. Historically, vegetarian alternative to burgers have tended to be thick, dry, almost cake-like and made from soya. Well, yes, made from soya. I can't agree with that. I haven't found them dry. There is a particular one I quite like. Linda McCartney's quarter-pound burgers with mozzarella cheese somehow injected into them. Oh, they're very, very nice. Sainsbury's do their own version of that for about 50 pence less. Very, very nice. Well, new techniques backed by tech billionaires like Bill Gates and the bosses at Google mean plants can be effectively turned into convincing versions of beef or chicken. Such is the sophistication, like this programme, sophisticated. Such is the sophistication of the science that these burgers, which are pink and juicy on the inside, could kill off expensive attempts to grow meat in the laboratory. So this thing bleeds as well. How awful. Oh, no, how awful. I was talking to someone. Who was I talking to someone yesterday? And they were saying they were having a burger and they cut into this burger and blood came out. I mean, how can you even want to eat something where blood oozes out of it? It's just disgusting. It is. Oh, no. Thank you very much. But that's good, isn't it? So if you want to try, eat less meat, then that might be something for you to try. Okay, let's do today's birthdays. Lots of birthdays. Oh, not too many today. There's only about five today, I think. Happy birthday today, Antonio Amore, who is 55 today. I didn't know you was old, a little bit older than me. Happy birthday, Antonio. Are you an Aquarius? Are we into Aquarius yet? because I'm an Aquarius. Less than a month to go before my big 54th birthday. Happy birthday, Antonio, today, 55 years old. He loves karaoke. He loves singing Barry Manilow. And he's been over here to the UK a couple of times singing with us as well. So happy birthday, Antonio. Hope you have a lovely day, sir. Happy birthday to Duncan Dale, 37 today. Duncan, I haven't seen you for ages, dear. Ages. 37, my God. Where's that gone? I think Duncan went to the same school as me. And what's happened to Michael? I haven't seen young Michael for ages, Duncan. Perhaps you'll come back to me under this, or perhaps with a little private message and let me know where how Michael's doing and where he is, what he's doing. Happy birthday today to Nicola Oates, who's 34 years old today. To Jordana Smith. Now, I think you're one of my karaoke girls, aren't you? Aren't you the Jordana who used to come to Blues's in Fulham, I think. I think I'm right there. Happy birthday, my darling. And happy birthday to the lovely Debra Lushey, who used to come along to the Black Cap when I was DJing there. And she's also friends with friends of mine. So happy birthday, Debra. Here's the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Antonio, Duncan, Nicola, Jordana and Debra. Happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful day, gang. It's Monday, so I'll be hosting karaoke. God knows how I'm going to get there tonight because there's an underground strike. And I've the feeling it's going to be a minimum of a two-hour journey in tonight. So I shall be leaving here at 5 o'clock tonight to get to it. Isn't it ridiculous? That's for an 8 o'clock start. So I'm going to leave here at 5 o'clock tonight and hopefully that will get me there on time. Karaoke tonight and every Monday with cheap drinks as well. And that is at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross in London. Do come and join us there. It's never a charge to get in. It's free entry and cheap drinks every Monday. So once again, tonight, karaoke at Central Station, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Cheap drinks as well. It starts at 8 o'clock and finishes at 11:30. Enjoy your Monday and we'll chat again soon. Bye-bye.